Please,
what is it? Turn left. I've got a new job.
Whoa.
Congratulations.
I've got a tilt at my claws.
It's okay. We can help.
As we see, we practice empathy in our everyday life. Empathy, the ability to sense other people's emotions, followed by with the ability to imagine what someone else might be thinking or feeling. For instance, I'm reading a novel. In the novel, the persona says that he was embarrassed. Now, as a reader, I add my own emotional energy to that powerful word to feel the persona's feeling, even though there's no other physical indication from the speaker. A new research has suggested there are 1-2% of population struggling to differentiate between their own bodily feelings and other people's. Furthermore, people with autism spectrum disorders have difficulties to empathize. Well, it's common for everyone to be egocentric at a moment, but the right supramarginal gyrus, which is the specific part of your brain, autocorrects when it recognizes a lack of empathy. These parts of our brain help us to tell a part of our personal emotional state from that of other people and is responsible for empathy and compassion. The supramarginal gyrus is a part of cerebral cortex and is approximately located at the junction of the parietal, frontal, and temporal lobe. So when this brain region doesn't function properly, it dramatically reduces one's ability for empathy. So what happens when there's a lack of empathy? It creates a psychological starvation that makes one act in extremely destructive ways, like reinforcing selfishness, narcissism, and at a far extreme psychopathy. In September 2013, the Department of Psychology at the University of Chicago suggested that people who are lack of empathy showed a typical neural response within the brain regions involved in empathy for pain, including the anterior insulae, the anterior mid-cingulate cortex, somatosensory cortex, and the right amygdala when pain is imagined to themselves. But when they imagined pain to others, these regions usually fail to become active, but increased response in the ventral striatum, an area known to be involved in pleasure. That proves these people are sensitive to the thought of pain, but unable to empathize. In conclusion, meditation, volunteerism, being non-judgmental, and daily physical activity can make your brain more empathetic. Vanakkam, I'm Elimas.